We'd like to invite you on a walk to the theatre. More specifically, the Metro Theatre, Sydney's premier venue for bands who can sell at least 1,000 tickets at least once. I know what you're thinking. That doesn't seem like a big enough deal to base an entire Rockumentary on, and you're right. For some bands, this venue is just the beginning. But for some bands, this venue is the star on the horizon. The ultimate goal. The edge of the map and the end of the line. Some bands spend so long trying to get there that they arrive without knowing it, blame everyone else for how long it took, and have absolutely no idea what they're supposed to do next. Bands like ours.
We've been dreaming of playing this venue for many, many years. Since we started busking, just a few blocks away. Here, Sydney's Pitt Street Mall. Vibrant and bustling epicenter of retail stores, street performers, and lunch. It doesn't look like this, obviously. That's a symbolic representation. We drew that. Arriving here will put us on the map, and from there it's a short walk straight down to the theatre. I'll bring this along as well, in case I need to make any changes. Hopefully once we get there, things will start to make sense.
Nice coffee, is it? I'll pack the van.
Because you at least need to be able to make sense of your own story. Well, we've got a great story. Yeah, you already know the story. Busk on the street for a few years, get signed by a major label, release an EP, then an EP, then an album. Sing along to yourself on the radio, headline Glastonbury, sell out Wembley, become the biggest band in the world, and then star in a film about yourself directed by Edgar Wright. Perfect. Except that's obviously not what happened. That's not our story. Our story is the one that happens while we're trying to figure out what our story is going to be. Because it feels like every rung that you climb just leads to another one. You know, it doesn't happen all at once, it's all one at a time. Next thing, next thing, next thing. Until finally you reach a point that to some might seem like the poetic realization of some faraway dream, not to you. Because you've been climbing this massive ladder, constantly watching it get closer and closer, then further away, then closer again. So when that big moment finally comes, you don't get the satisfaction of putting on your sunglasses in the dark, busting through the Metro Theatre doors and savoring the sweet, sweet taste of nostalgic reflection. You just say, yeah. Finally! And then become immediately concerned with where to put your ladder. So I've decided to make a film about it, obviously. We're gonna take a journey through our own past, present, and future, make it all into a nice, neat map. Hopefully, if we can retrace and reconnect, we can put every version of ourselves back into the puzzle until we're all here and we all understand. Let's go with that for now. It's not like we have anything else on.
Thank you. Welcome to the Echo of Youth Tour.
Probably could have rehearsed on a different day and then not been late today.
We're not late.
We are late.
No, we're normally later than we are today, so if anything, we're early.
No.
Be fine, everyone's there. It's all set up, all we have to do is arrive.
No one's coming, are they? So.
Why are you being so negative?
I'm not being negative. Not the being positive one.
What's that?
I said, I'm not being negative, and then I stopped talking.
Well, if you didn't forget the mandolin.
Really. I didn't forget the mandolin. You took the mandolin out of my car.
Put it in your house.
Where I wasn't expecting it to be.
Well, you forgot the mandolin.
I did not forget the mandolin. I did forget the mandolin, obviously. It didn't put it in my house. I often think about these moments. You know, the seemingly insignificant moments that are changing everything. Like last week, for example, we were half an hour late for our flight to Brisbane. Legged it to the airport, top of the stairs, front of the line. Somehow convinced the woman to let us on the plane. She says, boys, one more minute, you've had no chance. We just laugh and get on the plane. One more minute, you've had no chance, she said. 1 minute, 60 seconds. No chance as well. 60 seconds, no chance. One red light, we don't make that flight. One wrong turn, we don't play that gig. Imagine if we didn't have this. Anyway, get on the plane, play the gig, goes great, so we never think about it again. But what's the world in which we didn't make that flight? Am I sitting here talking to you about how we didn't play a gig in Brisbane last week and I wonder what it would have been like? Did the hundreds of conversations that we had before and after that gig ever get to exist? And are we different people because of that? A woman came up to us after that gig and said...
Which way are we going to Sydney? Same way.
Going to Sydney.
Normal way.
Yes. A woman came up to us after
that...
It's foreshadowing. A woman came up to us after that gig and said that our music saved her life. Now, how do you make sense of that? You know, it's too easy to lose perspective. Become numb, just float down the river.
That's where we are again.
She's asking where we are again.
Yes.
Tell her we're coming as fast as we can.
I know what we're doing. I'm telling her that.
Tell her on the bridge.
We're on the bridge.
Tell her to stop stressing how far away we are and just keep everybody calm.
I'm just going
to
tell her we're on the bridge.
This guy plugged his bass in. Joe set up his drums.
I'm just going to tell her we're on the bridge.
If we get there, guys have plugged his bass in and Joe has set up his drums. The whole thing's a schmance.
That way.
Just point.
Or don't walk up the ramp, find the stairs. No, walk up the ramp. Walk up the ramp. It's a
it's running.
The whole thing just seems like a problem of perspective. You don't understand the story while you're in it, and you can't remember the story once you're out of it. We used to spend 12 hours a day here, 3 days a week. That's 1,872 hours a year. 4 years of that, 7,488 hours spent here, and I can remember maybe five things from it. But even then, I don't know if they were memories or just stories I heard or videos I saw. And even then, they're not in the right order. Something I think happened on one day actually happened across six different days over 3 years, and I just stuck them all together. I don't remember coming this way. Anyway, we're here.
Songs are a bit like, this one's a bit more like, anyway, hope that cleared a few things up. A song called Too Many. Ooh.
mountains to climb, too many thoughts for my pen to write. Too many hours at night, too many pictures in black and white.
Just me, it's my way of life. we're a rock band now. We do rock and roll things like play solos. I jumped just now. You might have noticed I jumped. Yeah, we've been trying to become a bit more rock and roll. I said the F word last night in Brisbane. Ask Brisbane, man.
I know if you guys saw earlier, but I after like the first two choruses of the first song, I yelled the name of the place that I'm in. Saw it on a Rockumentary. Everyone goes nuts, they love it. And you guys proved us right. Weirdly, they didn't love it in Brisbane. They just didn't love it. It could have been because I said Melbourne, I'm not sure. But you guys loved it, and that's all that matters. We're not at the point where we can do like costume changes. That's the dream. That's the real dream. Or at least like destroy the stage at the end of the night for no reason.
It's difficult because a lot of this equipment is quite expensive, so it's... Shut up and sing from down the back.
Was it down the back or here? I was feeling it.
It's I, Madeleine. See you when I close my eyes. That's all that I will need. It's okay, I hear you say, as I let you float away. So what the hell does that make me?
That should be a good feeling. Yeah, just be good.
So sick from this tour!
Yeah.
you've been on to all but the sun.
Busking, do you still do that?
You guys have demonstrated like enormous self-discipline, because I read that you guys wake up at 4 a.m. on a weekend and you drive all the way down and then you wait at Busking Revolution for the main spot for up to 9 hours. How did you maintain like such an intense just like schedule and so much output?
The pair have quite an interesting backstory. Their musical journey started with them busking. So how did they transition into the professional scene?
Oh, it might have been that time the nun put $50 into their busker's hat. Apparently, though, she felt sorry for them.
We want to hold. After death, believe. you know when you just feel like you were asleep for 7 to 9 months? You know that feeling when you just feel like you got to wake up? Nah, me either. Sunday night, try not to hold too tight. Try not to ask her why she stayed so long. She'll say I was right. These habits will keep us tied. Somewhere in a sentence I failed to write. Moon fall down and turn us to shadows now. Here in the hands I found so long ago. Turned around, I am the other now. I cannot make a sound to save my life. Do you feel good?
I don't feel good.
Sunday night, try not to hold too tight. Try not to want. She stayed so long, but I cannot. She's everything I'm not. It's everything I've got. Put it down.
Do you feel good?
something else along those lines. It's okay, gone away, and it really spoiled my day. But I tell before the weather can bring her down.
It's not a straight line, is it? You can't put A in your phone and expect it to give you the best way to B. Maybe you can, I don't know. No, but what would B even be? Play Glastonbury? Be biggest band in world? Is that good enough? And what would it even say? Route 1 includes tolls, probably. Route 2 is 3 years faster but lacks a sense of fulfillment. Route 3 has heavy traffic, 3 speed traps and takes you through the tunnel of darkness. Route 4 avoids heavy traffic, speed traps and darkness but takes you through the bottomless lake of metaphors. Would you do it? If you could see it all in front of you? Surely, right? Because if we don't know the ending of our story, how can we really be the writers of our own script? Maybe we're just the pen. I don't know. We're running out of time. Listen. The bird of dawning singeth. You know, they say her song is, oh, it's just James. Oh, what a mess. I better go get him, actually. He doesn't like bridges. We'll see you for the next act.
Is daylight.
you guys, we are going to get off the stage and come hang out with you guys for a sec. We're going to play one of our oldest songs, and it's a song I showed to Jordan in my kitchen, and it was the first time he'd ever said he liked one of them, so...
No, it was the first one I've ever liked.
Yes. Yep. Let's do it. I think we're going to go around there and then into the middle. So please, stop coming.
What if no radio plays this album? We sell like 867 copies.
Yeah.
And then a year from now, we're not making enough money.
No,
we
but
haven't sold the albums we thought we were gonna.
I don't think we've been, because we've been doing it for so long. And I don't think we've just been saving up for the time when we get heaps of radio play and we start making heaps of money. It's like, it's not like we won't look back on these 6 years or 5 years, whatever it's been, and say that was tough, like that was a real struggle, we had to get through that, we weren't making much money, we weren't getting much radio play. Now we are, so how good is it? I think we just do as you do.
There's a vocal part here, it's very, very difficult. I'm going to teach it to you, all 1,000 of you. Very easy.
Get the mandolin. You took the mandolin out of my car.
Put it in your house.
Where I wasn't expecting it to be. Trust know where we are.
Trust know where we are again.
Yes, still.
Tell them on the bridge.
On the bridge.
Basically on the bridge. They don't know we're not on the bridge.
We're basically on the bridge.
We're on the bridge now. Tell them we're past the bridge.
We're on the bridge now.
Tell them we're coming around the corner into the alleyway and we're about to park.
We're coming around the corner.
Tell them we're there. Tell them we're already soundcheck.
We're all... They're soundcheck.
Tell them they're late.
It's not going to work.
Backing vocals that try to get you to be much better. What a bunch of wankers. The backing vocals, by the way, are a representation of our past selves. We don't actually hate our band. In fact, they're quite close friends of ours. That's past James and Jordan, anyway. Future James and Jordan, I know what to do. Yes. Yes, they'll travel the world and play their songs for millions of adoring Europeans because the world is made of voices.
Well, that's so. How many have we got left till sold out?
Till sold out, 375.
Right. Okay. Yeah. It's quite a few.
Plus guest list.
Do you have any friends in Stuttgart?
No.
Well then. So it's.
Well, not yet. I'm about to have 15 friends in Stuttgart.
They're the people that are already coming to.
We'll get out there. And we'll tune up and we'll just pump out the bangers and then just sort of ask everyone to dance.
Yeah, they want. They definitely want.
Say, hello, do you want to dance? And then...
You think they'll get up and dance?
I think we will have a mosh pit by the end. I think we will be stage diving.
Why being so positive?
I'm not being positive. No one's being positive.
Push my feet into the
pointless, all this. Not to mention bad. Maybe it can help you. It's genuinely helped me. I feel like every step through this place has felt like another pixel to the projection. Maybe you can do the same. Don't make a film about it, obviously. It's very hard to do that without coming across extremely self-obsessed. And no one cares about your life anyway. Ooh, you used to be a duo and you used to busk. Then you played a really big show that used to just be a faraway dream, and the next morning you woke up and you couldn't remember the show or how you got there. Suddenly you're like, yeah, maybe we're right. Maybe sitting in the cinema waiting for the film to start is better than the film itself. So you let your whole life go by until you're an old man, and you're like, oh, you used to be in a band, one. Then your grandkids are like, yeah, okay, whatever, granddad. Because your jetpack's on. I did learn one thing from past Jordan, though. Envy of yourself a year ago. equally useless as envy of a stranger today. Not what he said. He said something like that, less quotable. Either way, it's good advice. Future is flowers, James. The future is flowers.
Sounds really good.
You should definitely not stop the song there.
You should definitely end the tape at that point.
I just thought we were doing the bridge.
Well, fucked up, Jackson.
See no light.
matters as it seems. It's okay, I meant to say, I hope it always goes your way. But Madeline, don't change.
Their message? What are we going to be hearing from them?
They're reflecting the era they've grown up in. So technology and the way it impacts on the way we relate to each other.
Thousand people or 10,000 people a night. The magic is there, and that's what writes the story.
A thousand different stories, each with their own infinite potential, each colliding in the same space and time, singing the same words. That's magic, that has to be magic. Every decision, every conversation, every song, every dance, every fall into the tunnel, every death and every rebirth, they're not just memories, they're revolutions. Well, to be honest, I can't believe you're still here. It's been a very long walk. It'll be another year once we open that door before on whatever screen you're watching this on. I wonder what world surrounds that screen and where we are in it. Probably watching the screen as well, actually. I'm right though, aren't I? This has all been a bit selfish, expecting you to sit there while we retrace our very recent past in order to take one step into the future. There's an hour and a half you're not getting back. Has been 10 years though, to be fair for us. 10 years since we left school. Maybe it was stupid to think we'd ever left. I got the feeling we'll be learning right till the very end.
Or very end.
What?
Like in the world end, or even to the bitter end.
Or lager end. It's funny in the film because it's about beer though. This doesn't.
Not necessarily. Well.
Did you just speak to me?
Excuse me?
Can you hear what I'm saying?
I'm standing very close to you.
But this isn't in the monologue, what I'm doing.
No, it isn't.
Yes, it is?
No, I'm certain that it isn't.
Well, why haven't you said anything?
I have.
It's too easy to lose perspective, to be numb, float down the
river.
It's good advice.
Imagine if you put this much effort into remembering mandolins.
Future is flowers, James. Future is flowers. Wow, this is just great. I don't know what I'm up to anymore.
A bit about learning, listening, don't blame
me.
Oh,
yeah. It seems as though, well, you've said it now, there's
no point.
No, I'm doing it. It seems as though we must listen and learn forever.
Forevermore.
Forevermore, thank you. But all we can do is say on the ladder, each rung a heightened perspective, to risk the fall so that we might fly. Step once more into the carnival flat. Relevant into the dream, because none of us want the story to be boring. The story accounts for that which history and memory can't, and we better weave it with a thread strong enough to withstand time. We are each and every one of us the writers and actors of our own and each other's drama, so we should do our best to write and act something true.
Free ourselves of the pulling strings. Build with every broken brick the story of your dreams. Be what you want to be. This isn't nostalgia. Not even reflection. Fucking revolution.
Oh, shit.
Is it not open?
No, it's not open. I broke my glasses. Have you finished putting that on yet?
It's hard to see with sunglasses on in the dark. Have you tried pull?
No.
I'll try pull. See if it's... No, there's no door handle.
Just...
No door handle there.
We'll go around the front.
Just go around the front. We should go, though. We should go fast. Around the front.
Why should I have to try so hard not to love you the way you are? Why is it so hard to believe when I see you, you're all I see? No one knows that I think of you, but
Do you think they got it?
Like,
they get the film? I'm not sure I get the film, to be honest with you. It'd be a shame if no one notices that we've walked into the cinema.
Yeah, I think we'll have to make it a big deal.
Yes.
It'll have to be loud. I might say something like, it is us.
Oh, yeah.
We have arrived.
A vocal sort of performance.
Yeah, and sort of put my hands in the air. Yeah. Hopefully they cheer.
Bow, maybe.
Cheer loudly.
I might bow.
You bow, yeah. Go yeah. for it.
Just sort of accept the praise, you know.
Depends if they hated the film. If they hated the film, there won't be anyone there. Well,
they might
be
on
quiet.
Their way out, yeah.
Is this it? Is this it?
Is this the cinema?
Yes.
Okay, so it is.
Yes.
Where do I park?
It's busy. There's no parks.
I'm just going to park here.
Well, that's a loading zone. Let's, you can't just park.
We're loading up. Let's go.
Get out.
So you're putting your hands up and I'm going to bow.
Yeah.
Thank you very much. Thanks. Are you guys ready for more Winterbourne?